Hi everybody, welcome back to one of my free tutorials. I've been asked several times to, I guess, explain or try to talk a little bit about the design that I made some months ago. As you can see, the one that's here, it's actually a business card using social media icons. I want to talk to you a little bit about it, how I kind of derived the idea and the things that it took to put it together. Here you see it all complete. I'm going to take it away. We're going to have a blank screen. This is actually the size of an actual business card. And the business card is, I think, 3.5 by, we'll take a look. 3.5 by 2. And the resolution on this right now is at 150. So those of you that are following this and trying to learn a little bit about Photoshop, I'm going to try to touch on each item without being too tedious and too, you know, too slow. Try to make it interesting, try to make it involving, and so we'll go from there. Okay, this is the size, and I talked a little bit earlier about how I came across or thought about doing this business card using social media icons, and I wanted to do something kind of unique and different. So I was thinking and thinking, and I thought, you know, social media is basically, you know, getting in contact with people at the quickest possible rate and at the most convenient way to do it is by your cell phone, I think, right now. So anyway, I looked at the cell phones, and then I said, you know what, the iPod and the iPhone were really cool designs at the time that I did this, and lend itself really well because of the ratio and proportion of the iPhone to a business card to begin with. So here's what I came up with. I basically took an iPhone and redrew it, kind of, you know, made it so that I could, you know, work with it on the business card. If you notice on the inside, I kind of grayed out this, you know, the visual part that's going to contain most of the information, so that I can have like a clean slate. It happens to be slate coloring, as you can see, and work from that. Then I added the button, and basically it's a button with round circle with, you know, with the highlight at the bottom, kind of corresponding with the highlight that's going on here, and with the correct shadowing and that kind of thing. Next thing I did was add a bar at the bottom, and this bar right here was going to collect or have all these icons that made an article that I wrote some time ago about designing business cards with social media icons in mind. And so, you know, I decided I would use this idea, and it worked out. I mean, the article was well received, so I thought, now that I'm being asked to kind of go over the design with the Photoshop interest, I thought, okay, why not? Okay, so this is the bottom part that was going to contain all the icons, or some icons. I'd give you a good example of, you know, what icons are most popular or most being used. You know, everybody's getting into it now, so it's you know, you can have anybody's icon up here that you feel, you know, important enough. Okay, so then I added two buttons, and one was to point, you know, take you in a direction to your right or to your left, forward or backwards, and it was sort of indicate to you that, you know, that you were gonna be able to scroll as many icons as you could possibly scroll through, and click that icon and go straight to it. Anyway, next thing I did was I added this check mark to the design. And at the time that I did it, I really liked the check mark, but I didn't know if it was going to work or not. So I put it in there and I let it sit, kind of like with the visual part off, and later I clicked it on. I'm going to go back here to the bottom part to this bar, and the reason I'm going to go back here, I'll click it off too, so you can see which one I'm talking about. There's quite a few effects to that bar. Without the effects, this is what it looks like. With effects, this is what it looks like. Now, if you notice that there's some coloration in here, there's actually, if you look on the effects menu here, you can see all the effects that are involved in this particular bar here. First of all, the layer shows you the color that was predominant for this particular piece or layer. And then you see all the particular effects that were being used. So if I clicked on, let's say, the drop shadow, you can see the drop shadow. I'll put it in the center so you can see it. The drop shadow is set at 33, 23, and, you know, capacity 7. Now let's see what happens if I take off the drop shadow. Did it do anything? Yeah and no. You know, and a lot of people say, well, I don't know if that was really effective. But you know, even the most subtle things, believe it or not, can make a difference. So I'm going to go down the list here because you can see all the things that were involved in this. Here's the drop shadow on, and here again it's off, and you can see that there's you know, some effect, and there's a very slight effect, but again, there is an effect. Here's the inner bevel. And you can see that it does do something. What it did for me was it helped highlight this area right here a little more effectively. And the reason for that is because that's where I was going to do some work, where some lettering was going to appear, and I wanted it to sort of highlight that area that was going to highlight the lettering. Okay. Here it is, with and without. Again, you can see the effect. I liked it. It worked for me. Here is outer glow. Did it work? Did it not work? Did it work? Did it not work? Did it help? Did it not help? Did it help? Did it not help? Well, here's what I thought about it. Because, you know, these phones are light transferring mechanisms, and you're going to get their visuals by way of light transferring to your eyes. Anything that's the brightest is going to really shine and even actually glow. So, you know, I had some thought behind it, saying, well, does it glow this much or does it glow less than that? So I kind of fooled around with the, you know, parameters on that. And you can see here it's a screen, because if it weren't not a screen, nothing would really change. Anyway, these are the parameters. I made the opacity 35, so it wouldn't really like overshadow or overpower, rather, the whole thing. Okay, now going to inner glow. Yes, it helped for me. It helped for me because it helped concise or emphasize the area that was being worked on, or you wanted to draw that attention there, and it didn't spill out anywhere else. So yeah, it worked. Okay, bevel and emboss. Where did that happen? Well, you can see what happened there. If I turn it off and on, made this kind of beveling situation appear on top here, where I said I was going to put some titling later on. Okay, so satin, without it, with it, without it, with it. Well, I could have gone either way with this. You know, it's a very subjective. Everything is in art. I went with it because, you know, I didn't want it to be a color. I wanted it to be like kind of, you know, it was white, but it, you know, because of the shadows and the lights and the volume, it, you know, with the bar in the middle here, that it was going to, you know, make reflections of colors and things like that. So I stayed with it. Next comes the color overlay. And as you can see, that color overlay is the color that you see over here on the right with the layers. That color being this up here also. And I'll show you what that is. And why did I choose that color? Well, because it's that kind of translucent, soft light color. And I didn't want it to overpower, so I made it, you know, as soft as I possibly could to white, and, you know, or close to white that I possibly could, so it wouldn't overpower, like I said. Okay, let's move on. Stroke. With stroke, without stroke. With stroke, without stroke. With stroke, without stroke. What happened here? Not much, right? Well, if you look on the top, on the with the stroke, you can see that there's a line that is more visible at where I'm indicating here than it would have been without it. So it kind of, you know, brought the attention back to that area. So it looks like it's a part of the screen and not something that's sitting on top of the screen. It kind of like brought it into the screen. So I created that as part of the effects, and that's how we went along. So anyway, we're going to move on. Next thing I added was, we talked about the check mark. I'll turn it back on for now because everything's in place. Nothing has been moved around. Basically, I'm just turning on things for you so you can see how many layers there are, how many things that it took to make this business card. Okay, so here's a title, Jonathan David. He's the CEO. Another is fictitious name, fictitious address, and a fictitious company name. This is so easy to do because, I mean, here we are, you know, making an example of a business card without having a real name. It allowed so much freedom that I made a name that actually fit perfectly with the business card, and it just like put it together. Okay, media staffers, right? Oh, okay, so these people know everything about, you know, social media. Anyway, next is a bar on top, and it pretty much follows the same pattern as the bottom one. So, and it has all the, you know, same effects, except it's longer and thinner, and it doesn't have the blue. Okay, just doesn't have the blue. Why did I put the blue? Well, because I think with all the things that were going to go into the bottom part, you know, all the bottom part was going to contain all the icons, and all these icons had colors, and it was going to make reflections, you know, that would, and, you know, affect the background and things like that. Whereas the top one wasn't, so that's why I didn't put in the blue. And the blue, I think, would have been, you know, the reason for, you know, the reflection and, you know, the icons causing this reflection. Okay, next is what I said earlier. We're going to put some copy up here, and it was media staffers, and then your local time, like you would normally see on your iPod and or iPhone, rather, or both. Anyway, I'm going to skip and start adding these icons. Now, here's a shadow area here. And I If you notice that I added this shadow that was going to carry on with the highlight that was going to was actually started out at the beginning with the phone basic image, and so that's in there now. I'm going to start putting in the icons, and you know, I did this rather fast, so if you notice in between these icons, it's not really spaced properly. I said, okay, I'm just going to do this for this article, so you know, I don't have to be so precise. Okay, anyway, said it'll leave another. YouTube did not have a square background. I couldn't find one, or I couldn't locate one, so I had to make one. So I, you know, I kind of, you know, suggested that it had a background, like, you know, like the other ones did here, and then placed the YouTube over it, and it worked. And the last icon, and so basically that's it, except for the other information that said it was going to happen around right here. So I'll just turn those on. And these were the direct, you know, the direct addies that you, or addresses that you could, you know, that you could see on how to contact these people through Facebook or Twitter or whatever. This was /jdavid.com. This one was @davidj. And this one was /jdavid.com. This one was /davidj. Another one was /davidj. You know, and these were all kind of like made up, but yet you got the, you know, it was supposed to give you an idea of how to contact these people with these addresses and the icon. Now, it also suggests that if you pressed any of these from this particular phone, you would go directly towards or to their YouTube channel or their YouTube page, you know, their Facebook or whatever. And as a card, it kind of tells you basically the same thing, that if you wanted to contact them at Twitter, you had their address right down here, @davidj, and so on and so forth. Plus, you know, their brick and mortar address, telephone number, everything that you needed to contact them, you know, the traditional way. And that's how I came across, or came up with this idea for a business card using social media icons. I hope this helped you out. You know, I hope it didn't confuse you. I hope I helped you out more than I did confuse you. Let's put it that way. And I thank you for coming and checking this out. And there will be a lot more coming from me to help you out with Photoshop and other programs. Thank you again. We'll see you next time.